नमस्ते, हमेशा खुश रहो बिटिया। माय नेम इज जेवीएन मनीषा सिंह। टुडे आई एम टीचिंग यू प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ ड्राइंग एंड डिहाइड्रेशन। इन आवर प्रीवियस सेशन आई टीच यू अबाउट व्हाट इज ड्राइंग एंड डिहाइड्रेशन एंड इट्स द फैक्टर्स अफेक्टिंग ड्राइंग एंड डिहाइड्रेशन ऑफ फ्रूट्स एंड वेजिटेबल। देन नाउ लेट्स स्टार्ट द टॉपिक। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल सम स्मॉल इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ ड्राइंग एंड डिहाइड्रेशन। Drying and dehydration of fruits and vegetables is an age-old method to preserve these foods. Removal of water that is 75 to 90% present in fresh commodity results in reduction in the water activity and ultimately resistance against most of the deteriorative agents. The removal of water is carried out by the application of heat, and this heat is usually supplied in the form of solar energy or artificially generated hot air. Removal of moisture and exposure of heat often results in poor textural attributes, loss in nutritive value, that is vitamins, discoloration and loss of flavorings components. Although both drying and dehydration are interchangeably used, drying is referred to removal of water to an equilibrium moisture content, while dehydration is removal of water to an almost bone dry condition. A number of processing steps are carefully designed to check all these adverse effects of drying. Some of the new technologies have been introduced in recent years to produce wholesome and nutritive product. Partial dewatering by osmosis and impregnation soaking process before drying saves energy during drying and improves quality of dried product. Osmotic dehydration is gaining popularity as the dehydrated product is more stable during storage due to low water activity by solute grain and water loss. The low water activity resulted in fewer rates of chemical reactions, avoiding deterioration of the food. Osmotic dehydration in many cases is employed to increase sugar to acid ratio of acidic fruits, thereby to improve the taste, texture and appearance of dried product. The processing steps involved in drying of fruits and vegetables are summarized. Then, why drying of foods? Water activity is defined as the ratio of vapor pressure of food to that of the vapor pressure of pure water at a constant temperature. Reduction in water activity, so control or check over chemical and microbiological changes, that is deterioration. Reduction in weight, size and volume of the food material, hence bulk transportation becomes easier and cheaper. Packaging requirements that are simple and cheap facilitate further processing, for example, grains drying for flour making. Then water is present in the food as free or bound water. Free water is defined as a water within the food that behaves as a pure water. Unbound water is removed during the constant rate period of drying when the nature of food does not have a great effect on the drying process. Bound water can be defined as the water that exhibits a lower vapor pressure, lower mobility and greatly reduced freezing point. So bound water molecules have different kinetic and thermodynamic properties than ordinary water molecules. The water activity as affected by the extent of bound water, that is given in the table, that is water activity as affected by the extent of bound water, that is extent of bound water or water activity. Tightly bound water, then water activity is not greater than more than 0.3. Moderately bound water is, tightly bound water, then water activity is less than 0.3. Then moderately bound water, then 0.3 to 0.7. Loosely bound water, the water activity is more than 0.7. And free water, that is 1. What is the drying principle? When hot air is blown over a wet food, heat is transferred to the surface and latent heat of vaporization causes water to evaporate. Water vapor is diffused through a boundary film of air and is carried away by the moving air. This creates a region of lower water vapor pressure gradient established from the moist interior of the food to the dry air. The gradient provides the driving force for water removal from the food. This is the moisture movement in the cell of food cells. This is the food surface and interstitial spaces in between the two cells. And when moving air is in this direction, then moisture movement is in upward direction. Then liquid movement by the capillary force, diffusion of liquids caused by concentration gradient, diffusion of liquids which are absorbed in layers at the surfaces of solid components of the food, and water vapor diffusion in air spaces within the food caused by the vapor pressure gradients. Then phases of drying. First of all, initial warm-up period, constant drying rate period, and falling drying rate period. In hygroscopic food material, more than one falling rate period occurs. In the first period, plane of evaporation moves inside the food and water diffuses through the dry solids to the drying air. It ends when plane of evaporation reaches to the center of food and the partial pressure of water falls below the saturated water vapor pressure. Second falling rate period occurs when the partial pressure of water is below the saturated vapor pressure and the drying is by desorption. Falling rate period is the longest period during drying of food product. Equilibrium moisture content occurs when dry spots develop at the surface, so less area exposed to dry air and evaporation decreases. This is the diagram that shows the change in moisture content with time. Here is the moisture content and here is the time. AB is the warming up time, BC is the constant rate drying period, then CD is the first falling rate drying period, and D is the second falling rate of drying period. Then drying rate is dW by dT. There are four resistances to heat transfer in drying, that is resistance to external heat transfer, resistance to internal heat transfer, and resistance to external mass transfer, resistance to internal mass transfer. Then what is drying time? Drying time is the total time required to remove for removal of water from food material. Drying time during constant rate period is inversely proportional to the wet bulb depression, while drying rate is directly proportional to the wet bulb depression. Drying time T is equal to WT minus WI multiplied by rho S into L into D divided by H upon T alpha minus TW. That is then where WI is the initial moisture content, WT is the moisture content at time T, the bulk distance, bulk density of solid, L is the latent heat of vapor, D is the thickness of the material, H is surface heat transfer coefficient, T alpha is dry bulb temperature of hot air, dW is wet bulb temperature of air, and T alpha minus TW is equal to wet bulb depression. Then factors affecting the drying rate is the factors that affect drying rate are external and internal factors. External factors are the dry bulb temperature, relative humidity, air velocity, and surface heat transfer coefficient, whereas internal factors are surface to volume ratio, surface temperature, rate of moisture loss, and composition, that is moisture and fat. Then mechanism of osmotic dehydration. In osmotic dehydration process, a solid product of high moisture content is immersed in a concentrated solution, that is mainly of salt and sugar, which initiates three types of counter current mass transfer, and the diagrammatic presentation of osmotic dehydration in the another slide. Then water outflow from the product to the surroundings solution as a result of osmosis through a semi-permeable membrane. Then solute transfer from the solution to the product. Third is leaching out of the water soluble component along with the water from the product to the solution. The last two mass transfers occurs mainly because of diffusion. This countercurrent mass flow is due to the water and solute activity gradients across the cell membrane. This process continues till the osmotic potential on two processes reaches equilibrium. In an ideal osmotic solution, a semi-permeable membrane would be permeated by the solvent molecules but not by the solute molecules. In fruits and vegetables, the cell wall membranes are living biological units and selective permeable, which can stretch and expand under the influence of growth and the torsion pressure regenerated inside these cells. These cellular membranes, which are composed mainly of parenchymatous cells, freely allow the solvent molecules to pass through, but they also allow to a lesser degree the passage of some of the solute molecules. Such membranes are called as differentially permeable rather than semi-permeable. Osmotic dehydration may result in 40 to 45, 50% of decrease in initial volume if properly performed. This is the diagram. This is a food material. Water is removed from the food and it is moves outward from the food, and solutes moves in the inward. And products own solutes, that is mineral, sugar, organic acids, etc., all are moved outward. So that's the osmotic dehydration principle. Then osmotic agents and their requirements. Osmotic agents must have lower water activity, good solubility, constant concentration during processing, and it should be cheap. However, non-toxicity, inertness to the food constituents and good sensory attributes in other added attraction while selecting any osmotic agent. These are the number of compounds available satisfying above mentioned criteria like sucrose, glucose, syrup, invert sugar, corn syrups, honey and humectants such as sorbitol and glycerol. The kind of sugar utilized strongly affects the kinetics of water removal, and by increasing the molecular weight of osmotic substance, larger water removal could be achieved with little uptake of solutes. Low molecular weight substances like glucose, fructose, sorbitol, etc. favors the sugar uptake because of the high velocity of penetration of the molecules, so that the solid enrichment instead of dehydration is the main effect of the process. Sodium chloride is an excellent osmotic agent for vegetables and other animal-derived products, but its use with fruits is restricted because of the alteration in taste and bleaching of the color. Addition of sodium chloride to osmotic solution increases the driving force for drying owing to the water activity lowering capacity of the salt, and synergistic effects between the sugar and the salt has also been observed. The use of blends comprising two or more solutes seems to be an attractive alternative. And we are using less 25% of salt or brine for the osmotic dehydration. Hope this session, you all are satisfied with this session. This session is powered by Digital Version 2.0 Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University, Jaipur. If you have any query, please mention it in a comment box. I will resolve them whenever I have a live class. Thank you so much.